Hey guys, what's up? Elias here with the Yes Do It team, and in this training we're going to be talking about the three factors that you need to take into account for your website to be a really nice magnet of leads, a really nice flow of customers. These days, a lot of websites out there are only informative, are only showing people the regular, the most common, you know, about us section, products or services. If they are crazy, they go with contact us, maybe testimonials, and then call it a day, right? That's all they have. And it's almost a sin, you know, with everything that costs to make a website, with everything that you have to put out, not only in terms of money, but in terms of creativity, in terms of content, all of that information that they just put there, just there for the hell of it, you know, just there sitting, waiting for people to be like, oh, this is amazing, what an amazing product, what an amazing service is. It is only information. I'm gonna go and look for the number right now and call the company. I know that's how we expect that it'll work, but that's not the way it works. The way it works is that if you use your website only for that, the only thing that you will get out of it is some views, but nothing else than that. You won't even get people contacting you from the contact us page because it's old fashioned. Nobody even does that anymore. Only if they really have to do it. For example, if today I go out and buy an item on Amazon and it doesn't get delivered, I am probably going to go ahead and look for the support page on Amazon and, you know, open up a ticket because it's my package that I'm waiting for. But if this is a service that I am trying to look for, I am probably going to be just taking a decision for the next company that I find that looks similar to what I am looking for. So you really want to take your people and bring them to an action. It's not bad that you have these sections on your page, on your website, but make sure that you always end up with a call to action. That is number one rule. End up with a call to action. The second thing that you want to take care of is the weight of your website. How much does it really weigh? You know, how much does it cost for me to download? Because at the end of the day, when I go ahead and open up my phone and go to yesdoit.com, what it does is that it goes and opens up a page on our server. It starts downloading all the files and the different assets needed for that page to work and for it to look beautiful. And for that to happen, you need data, you need an internet connection. And if you are on a prepaid plan, for example, you're going to be losing money right there depending on how much does this website takes to load, basically. And if your website is too heavy, if your website has too many files, too many images, and they are not compressed, your website is going to be a little bit heavy and chances are people are not going to wait for it to load. So not only will you not be able to show them the information, they just didn't get to the page at all. They got tired of waiting. That is the second thing that you want to take care of. And the third one is use it in a mix with your social media platforms. Don't just leave it standing there for people to find it on Google searches. Because if you only do that, if you don't bring traffic to it using your social media platforms, using paid traffic, using other traffic sources, chances are nobody is really going to see your website. Nobody is going to really see your information. Nobody is going to even care about it. You want to be able to bring, you know, to create that organic traffic and send it to your website. Use it in a mix. For example, let's say that you are doing a giveaway on your Instagram page, right? Send the people from your link in bio, from the link in your bio, in your description, to your funnel, to your website. Say like, if you want to participate, make sure to go ahead and check the link in our bio. And that link in your bio actually sends them to your website in a specific page where they can simply leave their contact information, like their name, their phone, and their email. This way you actually make them interact with each other. And this way they are not two platforms working separately, but actually one only working together for you to get more leads, for you to get more traction, and of course for you to get more sales. So if you want to get more people to your funnels, to your website, to your contact page, to your About Us page, make sure to be able to create that traffic, to be able to create that flow of customers from your social media to your website. That being said, guys, thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys in the next video. Ciao, ciao.